Hello guys and welcome to another exciting video on this channel. In this video I'm going to talk about phones. More importantly, I will cover the legal aspects of phones, some of the famous phones that you might see on different phone websites. So you might find different famous phones on different websites and you will be tempted to use them, or maybe if you have a favorite TV show or movie and you find that font of the title of the movie or the TV show very good, and then you can see that you want to use it. So is it really legal to use it, or you can say you might find fonts similar to the ones that are used in movies or TV shows or maybe for famous brands? So can you use those fonts that you find online, and if the fonts or those fonts are listed as for commercial use? So I'll be covering these aspects of the fonts. So before I do that, I should mention here that this is not a legal advice. I'm not an attorney, so for legal advice you must consult an attorney. This is something that I have found on the internet, and the knowledge that I wanted to share with you. Now, intellectual property rights for fonts are different for different countries, and for that you must understand what is the difference between a typeface and a font. So in simple words, the font is actually a file name or a file that you download from the internet, or you get it through any medium. The one thing that you install in your computer, that is that file, the actual file is actually called a font, or you can say it is a software, and that is actually protected by copyright laws in the United States. So my future views in this video are going to be talking about the laws in the United States, because that's where most of the business, online e-commerce businesses are done. So I'll keep that in view. Now let's talk about what is the typeface. Now typeface are actual the characters or the drawings of the characters of a certain font. So these things are called the typefaces, or you can say the glyphs, or which are mostly used, the term that is mostly used in this regard. So that is called the typeface, and the typefaces are actually not copyrighted in the United States. They are not protected by copyright laws. In order to make you understand it well, I'll give you an example here. You already know a famous font, Helvetica. Now you will be surprised to know that Helvetica itself is not a font. It is the name of a typeface, and there are different versions of this Helvetica. For example, Helvetica Light, Light Oblique, Roman, and all these other versions that you find online, those things are called the fonts of you can say the files that you get from that particular style is called the font. Now why Helvetica is not a font and it is a typeface? Typeface actually gives you an idea of different characters, different drawings, the way the characters are drawn, something similarity between all the characters of same type of font. For example, here Helvetica Light, you can see that all these characters are drawn in a light. They are not bold, they are not thick, they are just simple characters, and you will be able to see that the curves that you see here in the O of brown and the B, these curves and the C, all of these will be similar to one another. So these kind of similarities, the way the characters are drawn, the similarities between different characters in a specific font is known as the typeface, or you can say the typeface of a particular font. So this is interesting thing is here that the typeface itself is not actually copyright protected by US. This might give give you an idea that you can use the fonts that are shown on the titles of movies, TV shows, or maybe brands. But it is not that simple. For example, you already know the famous brand Coca-Cola. So Coca-Cola has a trademark for its name of the company, that is Coca-Cola, and it is not a typeface or text trademark. It is actually an illustration trademark. So it means that the way these characters are drawn in their logo are actually trademark protected. They might not be copyright protected, but they are protected by trademarks. So you will also be able to find a similar looking font here on thefont.com, and this logo of font, and it says that it is 100% free, which means you can use it for commercial purposes. Now legally this font is not the same font that Coca-Cola company is using, because whenever a company or TV show or movie uses a font for its branding, they created from scratch mostly, or you can say to protect their rights and to make themselves and their brand looks unique. So that is the case. So whenever you find different fonts online similar to different movies, shows or brands, they are not the exact fonts that they are being used in those brands or identity of those artwork and marketing work. So this might give you so you might think that you are actually okay to use these fonts to in your own commercial projects, for example print on demand. That is what I'm talking about. There are other different famous fonts that you might find online, and you will be able to see that they are actually free for commercial use. The license says that they are free for commercial use, but the characters that they have drawn in these fonts, or you can say the typefaces of those fonts, are similar to the famous movies and famous TV shows and similarly the brands. So you might think that, should I use these fonts or not? In my opinion, legally you can use these fonts, because these are typefaces are not actually protected by the laws, and file format, or you can say the font file that is actually protected by the law, is not the same file as the same as the movie or a brand. But sometimes what happens is that those brands or those movies or TV shows, they get copyright of a specific characters of those words. For example, here I have shown you that Coca-Cola has this trademark for these characters, COCA and COCA, COC, COLA, Coca-Cola. So the way these characters are drawn, you cannot draw C in the same way as this brand has drawn, or L or A O. You cannot draw these characters in the same way and use it in commercially. But here you can see that the word cola is actually very similar to the one that they have brand for, trademark for. So in this way you cannot actually use those characters, because they are very similar to ones that are already trademarked. Now what happens if something is actually not trademarked, but it is used in famous movies or something like that? Now here what the gray area lies, because as I already said, the typefaces are actually not copyright protected in the United States. But what happens if you sell that product in other countries? So each and every other country might have different laws regarding these typefaces and fonts. So in some countries these typefaces itself are protected, so you cannot use the fonts similar to the ones that are already being used by famous brands or identity of movies or something like that. So you cannot use it in those countries. But what happens in United States? Now legally you can use it, okay, but it does not give you a free license to use it. You might think that it is legally to use it, but can you really use the same characters that are shown in the movies or the posters or branding of the movies or TV shows? In my opinion, you shouldn't use it. It is a risk that you should not take, because if what happens if the that big studio comes and sues you for you're making your characters similar to the ones in the poster work, because that poster and the text on that poster of a particular movie or show is actually copyright protected, because that is an artwork. Although they are not giving you the font or complete typeface, but that the way the poster designed, the way the characters are actually drawn on those posters are actually copyrighted. So if you use, for example, if the name of the movie starts with T and you draw certain phrase on your t-shirt using the same design of the word T, so that will give you in trouble. And also it is not really, you can say, I will say that, a good idea to use this thing, because what happens if other studio sues you? You will still have to pay your legal fees, pay your lawyer to fight for your right, even if you are right. And at the end, if you still win the case, you will still be have to pay the fees of lawyers and all that, and all the legal stuff, and all the trouble that you have to go through that. So think for yourself, is it really something that you should do, you can take it or not? In my opinion, this is not the thing that I can risk, or you can say it is not a good use of my time to deal with all that. So at the end the decision is yours, so you can make your own decision regarding this. But that is what I think about this. Another thing that I should mention here, that whenever you are going to use the font for a commercial purpose, maybe for a logo design, maybe for you know, print on demand purposes, you should read the license for a particular font. As I have shown you this website, thefont.com, and there are several fonts on this website and that are labeled for you know, free for personal use. And even if you search these fonts and look for the 100% free fonts or the you know, the public domain fonts, some of these fonts, when you download the font, you'll get a readme license, or you know, you're going to say license file in that, which describes the complete in details of the license, or you can say uses of that particular font. So you should read those individual files, or you can say individual licenses for your fonts as well, because sometimes it covers the over, and when you download the file, you can think that it covers the simple word or phrase that is written here, you know, 100% free or free for personal use, that covers everything when using that font, but it does not. So you should always read the license for a particular font that is given in the file that is downloaded. And that was another tip from me. And other thing that you should mention is that some of the websites, they allow the use for commercial purposes, but they restrict the way the font is used for commercial purposes. For example, they allow you to use the font for a you know, printing t-shirts or something like that, but they will restrict the copies of t-shirts that you can actually print, or you can see the quantities of t-shirts that you can actually print using that font. So you need to keep that mind in as well. And if you buy the fonts, that is, you know, totally illegal. You don't have to worry about all that, because when you buy the font, you know, after reading the license, that you can use it for print on demand purpose, that is the easiest way to go. But still, there are a lot of other free fonts that are totally free, that are, you know, 100% free fonts. I have made previously made a video regarding this, from where you can find 100% free fonts and that are actually legal to use in print on demand. So make sure you check out that video as well. And in this video, if you have found something interesting, something useful for your business, make sure that you like the video and also do subscribe to my channel. On this channel, I share tips and strategies and tricks to make a decent living online and to create a stable and source of passive income. So if you are interested in this, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and don't forget to press that bell icon so that you can be notified about my future videos as well. And if you have any questions regarding this video or regarding any of my videos or anything related to the print on demand, the videos that I already made, you can ask me in the comments below and I'll try my best to answer those questions. And thank you for watching.